These are the monthly sales of a business, from 2010 to 2022. From these charts of individual years, you may observe a trend that sales follow each year. They go up and down, with a little variation, during the same period of the year. These ups and downs are called seasonality. By observing these changes, we can predict the future sales as well. In this tutorial, we will create a dashboard, which will attempt to explain this seasonality, and to predict the next year sales as well. First, we will import the data from MS Excel file to Power BI desktop application using Get Data feature. We will select the sales table in Navigator window and press Load. Once the data is loaded, we will use it in our dashboard. We will start with adding a title to our dashboard, using a text box visual. We will add a line and column chart, to display last year's sales and customers' data. We will add the sales field, to the line y-axis. And the customers field, to the column y-axis. We will add the month from date hierarchy, to the x-axis. This chart shows the total sales per month, during all the years. We want the sales of last month only, which is 2022. To show the data of only 2022, we will add the year field, to the filters, with basic filter type. Then we will select only the year we want to show, the year 2022. We will then create a copy of the existing chart and remove the 2022 filter from the chart. This will again show the total sales, but we can change the customers and sales field to average to show the month-wise average sales. A comparison of both charts already suggests a strong correlation between average monthly sales and monthly sales during 2022, which is an evidence of strong seasonality. Now, we will use data analysis expression to analyze the monthly sales data. First, we will extract month number from dates and show it in a column which we will add to the sales table. Now, we will create a new table, with distinct month numbers, from sales table. Then, we will calculate average sales in a new column, against each month, using DAX. We will use the calculate function to calculate the average sales. We will use the average sales as expression. We will add a filter to calculate average sales against each month, from sales table. Average of sales will be calculated in the sales table, where month number in sales table is equal to the month number in sales analysis table. Let's format the column, using the comma sign in formatting group. We will use the same formula we created for the average sales, to calculate the maximum sales, against each month. And the same formula will be used to calculate the minimum sales against each month in a new column. Finally, we will make a small change in the same formula to calculate sales for 2020 against each month for comparative analysis. Here we have used the sum function here, but using sum, maximum, minimum, or average, will give the same result. Because against each month, there is only one sales value, in the sales table, in 2022. The more important thing is, that we will add another filter, to take only data from 2020. Therefore, in this filter, we will take only those dates that are greater than January 1, 2022. And finally, the sales analysis using DAX is complete. Now we will add some charts to our dashboard that will give some insight into the seasonality of the sales data, and they will also help us predict the next year's sales. First, we will add a line chart to our dashboard. We will add the 2022 sales to the y-axis, the month numbers to the x-axis, and the average sales to the secondary y-axis. This chart helps us understand the seasonality of the sales data by comparing the sales in 2022 with the average sales from 2010 to 2022. We will create a copy of this chart to display a trend line between the two data. We will convert this chart to a scatter chart. And then we will turn on the trend line. This trend line shows a direct positive correlation between the average monthly sales and the sales in 2020, again affirming the seasonality of sales data. We will create a copy of this chart to predict the sales of next year from historical data. We will convert the scatter chart to the area chart and remove the 2022 sales from the area chart. No, we already have the average sales in the area chart. We will also add the maximum sales and the minimum sales to the y-axis. By looking at this chart, we can comfortably predict that the sales during 2023 can be around the average line. In addition, the maximum sales cannot be expected to cross the maximum sales line, and similarly, the minimum sales cannot drop below the minimum sales line. There is another visual which can be used to compare sales of different years, to analyze and understand similarities, patterns, and seasonality. And that is a line chart, with years in small multiples. First, we will create a simple line chart, with months in x-axis, and the sales in y-axis. Then, we will add the years to the small multiples. And now, we can compare monthly sales of all years in a single visual. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.